to the Wake Up Call channel, newly released footage, body cam footage from the Donald Trump assassination attempt is a must-see. It's a must-see for a lot of reasons. Number one, you have to ask yourself the question of why they're releasing this footage. And if you're paying attention to the narratives, what they're trying to do is they're trying to bait the MAGA cult followers of Donald Trump into thinking that this was a deep state Democrat coup to try to have him killed. The footage you're going to see will show you police officers seeing the shooter on top of the building a good 39 seconds before shots were fired. One of the police officers pops his head up on the building, and instead of doing his job as a police officer, of course, he runs away from the scene only to allow the shooter to get the shots off. Which just shows us that this right here is a staged event. The narrative that they want out there is that Donald Trump is such a savior for humanity, for conservatives, that the deep state is trying to kill him, that the deep state is doing everything they can now to silence this story. And what they're doing is actually gaslighting them by not talking about this story anymore. And by releasing body cam footage, which shows police officers being completely incompetent. What else does it show? Well, it shows local police complaining about the Secret Service. So in this video clip that I'm about to play for you, you'll see police officers complaining that the Secret Service didn't do what they were supposed to do. While, of course, the police officers themselves climb up and see the shooter and then run away from the shooter, right? The narratives that are out there, newly released video shows chaos and confusion after Trump assassination attempt. So when you see these headlines, you have to start asking yourself, well, what are they trying to make people out there feel? They want to make sure that all the conservatives out there feel that this was nothing more than the deep state trying to take out Donald Trump. And we see that they fully believe this. They refuse to believe that the left and the right are working together, that they are in deep the psychological operation. They refuse to believe it. The other stuff to note while you watch this video clip, it's at the beginning of the clip that they released. Remember, they don't have to release this. They deliberately release it. So you have to ask yourself why they're releasing this. How often do they release body cam footage? Sometimes they do, but in a lot of events, they don't. They release this footage. Why? Because they want you to see it. They want you to see incompetency. They want you to see how clearly it looked like nobody was doing their job, so that you think that this was done on purpose, that these people were put in these positions to allow Donald Trump to get assassinated, when the fact of the matter is this is a staged event. The other thing to note, in addition to the audio being out for the beginning of the clip, and then, of course, the officer shuts his body cam footage off right as they get to the roof. Now, why would you ever do that? Why would you shut the body cam footage off right when you get up to the top of the roof? Something made him shut off his body cam. So the police officer who, in the beginning, climbs up, sees him, runs away, runs around, you'll see the footage yourself where he's talking to himself. He's like, the shooter turned on me. I mean, it looks like it's out of a cheesy film. And then when he gets up to the body, he decides to shut his camera off. And of course, the obvious thing to note is the clock. You'll see on the screen 18, the hour 18, which is really 6. That's military time. It's 6 p.m. 6:11:33 is when the shots were fired. So you have your 666, your 6 with the 11. You have your 33 coding right at 6:10:54, which will show up as 18:10:54 on the screen. And at 18:11:33, the first shot is fired with no police officers doing anything to stop it from actually happening, which gives the perspective to the MAGA audience that they're allowing it to happen, that they wanted it to happen. Instead of looking at it and saying it, what it really was, which was a staged event where they conveniently missed the year of Donald Trump. And remember, the type of technology they have, if they wanted him dead, he'd be dead. I mean, there's videos, there's things you can look up of the type of weaponry the government has. One of the funnier things that are out there is even like 1975, when the CIA had a committee, a Senate committee hearing, where they were talking about how they could fire pistols that would shoot shellfish toxin as poisonous ammunition onto people and kill them without them even knowing it. There's all these weapons that are out there. If they wanted Donald Trump out, they could have taken him out a million times. They could have taken him out, like I said, on a golf course, okay? They did this event in front of everybody because they wanted everybody out there to see it, because it plays into this production that they're producing. So without further ado, take a look at this body cam footage that was conveniently just released.
Dude, you guys have access to that junk that I love so much. You don't mind if I go off teleprompter, do you? Because these teleprompters are so damn boring, I try and explain that. Oh, there's a wow. You guys are doing it. They're getting better with time. My guys, take a look at that chart. Take a look at the arrow on the bottom. See the big red arrow, right? So that's when I left office. That was the lowest point, and that comes right from the government services. Comes right out of Border Patrol. Take a look at that. So that arrow is the lowest amount of illegal immigration ever in recorded history into our country. And then the worst president in the history of our country took over. And look what happened to our country. Probably 20 million people.
Lay down.
Secret Service on top of those buildings. You wouldn't have them completely empty. That way, if somebody was on top and it wasn't Secret Service, they could have seen him and taken him out. But what you saw is the police officers clearly see the guy, run away from the guy, and then you see all the confusion in between. You see bumbling around. You see the police officer even struggling to put his magazine in his... he can't even load his gun properly, right? And then, towards the end, they don't even have a ladder to get on top of the roof. They're trying to figure out how to get on top of the roof, and then you see the shooter lying there as he turns off the camera, right? Again, why would you shut the camera off right at that point? It makes no sense. So these things are getting released, and of course, this is all psychological. So everybody out there who's a MAGA cult follower, and that's what they really become, is a cult in a sense. They refuse to listen to reason. You could show them everything in the book, and they refuse to believe it, which is scary. It's scary and it's sad, but that's how this entire operation works, right? It's psychological. It's in your mind. So these people are so invested in this. They refuse to actually come out of it. And every little thing that they're doing deliberately, they don't realize that they're doing it. The media is doing it to get them to love and support Trump more. So by them not talking about the assassination anymore, everybody out there is noticing that. Why aren't they talking about the assassination? Why aren't they talking about the assassination, right? So they're getting angry that the media is not covering anymore. They know this. That's why they're not covering it. They're trying to bait you, right? Then they release the body cam footage. We actually have local police officers stumbling around, which makes them even angrier that there wasn't proper people in place. And then you have the local police complaining again about the Secret Service. That's the narrative they want out there, that the Secret Service was in on. That narrative of sabotage from within. His own people around him can't be trusted. The government themselves are trying to take him out. And again, they could have taken him out. They can take him out whenever they want. He's a sitting duck, really, for as a civilian. If the government wants to take you out, they can take you out. Okay? And if you're sitting on a golf course every other day where clearly these people know where they could find you, they know where you are at all times, it's the same type of psyop we see over in Ukraine. Where they're like, oh man, Russia wants to take out Zelensky. Meanwhile, Zelensky's on national television every day. He's at the Grammy Awards. He's all over the place. And they still haven't taken him out, right? But the whole goal was supposedly to take out Zelensky. And these people just eat the bait. They drink the Kool-Aid, so to speak. So other narratives that are out there is that Trump just spoke again. And what did he speak about? Well, he spoke about how he's a fast healer, right? He's a fast healer. They want you to know he's a fast healer because they don't want you to catch on at all to the fact that his ear is perfectly fine. They don't want you to catch on to the fact that his hand, when he said his hand was covered in blood, there was no blood on his hand. And of course, how he posed for that photograph, because that's what the entire simulated event was about. If they really wanted him dead, they would have killed him at any point in time. They could have went after him and taken him out, right? They wanted it on TV. They wanted it at a rally. They wanted everybody to see it. And he had to stage himself for that photograph, because that photograph is causing the hysteria, the psychosis, to worsen and worsen, and it's only gotten worse over the last couple of weeks. We haven't seen a psychosis like this in a long time, where so many conservatives / Christians are falling in love so much so with a political figure, and thinking that they're seeing stuff, right? That's what's scary. They're thinking that they're seeing these things. Like, oh man, did you notice the media's not covering? When the media's doing this stuff deliberately so that you react and say that, right? They're releasing this body cam footage to make you even think deeper and deeper that it's the deep state, that it's the Secret Service that is allowing this to happen. They're thinking that they're discovering this stuff by being detectives themselves. I mean, they're just feeding them all of this. They don't understand that when you watch things through the lens of the television set, you're watching it through a lie. You're watching a simulated reality. they can't get to that point, and that's the problem that they're having. But Trump again talked about his ear and how he's a fast healer.
Yeah, pretty much recovered. Yeah, I'm a fast healer. It's a hell of a shot, but I'm a fast healer. Yeah, pretty much recovered. No, it didn't hit that. I got very lucky. It just hit the lobe, as they call it. Yeah, a little bit, not much. On top. A little bit.
Right, and he's a real fast healer. So, other things to know with the body cam footage, again, like I mentioned, the timestamps, and other things that are out there are stories about how the Democrats are trying to tank the ticket, right? This is a theme that they want to have to dig at the underlying theme with everything I showed you, and then stuff like this. Carrie Lake saying, is she trying to tank the ticket? People are stunned by Kamala Harris picking Tim Walz. Tim Walz, if you don't know, is as liberal as it gets. He's as ridiculous as it gets. This is a guy who's putting tampons in the men's room, mandating it. All these things, that this, and they deliberately did this. They picked somebody who would be able to gaslight conservatives into whether or not they want to move state to state, but they're also making it completely unbelievable, right? They're picking two of the most incompetent people that you could possibly imagine. That's done by design, right? Kamala Harris and this guy Walz. Everybody looks at it like, oh, there's no way, right? The Republicans and the media are trying to say, well, they're sabotaging their own ticket. There's no way they're going to win, which tells me more and more that it's likely they are going to win this fake election so that they can bring down the infrastructure. The more unbelievable they make the ticket, the more ridiculous they make this charade, the more easy it'll be to manipulate and move people around. And keep in mind the other theme with this guy Tim Walz and with Kamala Harris is the fact that we're actually going to have somebody running for president, supposedly running, right, which is not real, which this whole thing proves to you. That didn't even receive a vote to be put in the position to run for president, right? They're just placed in the position. Kamala Harris is being placed, and it shows you how dumbed down society is and how much so these people know that nobody out there is paying attention and nobody out there cares, that they can take Kamala Harris. She doesn't have to be elected. She doesn't have to be voted into the position to be the Democratic representative. All she needs is an endorsement from a few people like Barry Sortoro, Barack Obama, and Hillary Clinton. They can place her in. That's not legal. That's not how this system works. You can't just, a bunch of people who aren't in power anymore can't just say, we want that to be the person, and then put them on television and say, they're the candidate. The people are supposed to vote. And it shows you how ridiculous this is, which makes it seem even more likely that they will put them in those positions as president and vice president, because these are people who will destroy the infrastructure. These are the types of people, Kamala and Tim Walz, that will be able to take conservatives and move them to states or make them become completely unhinged, that they'll do whatever the conservative political figures tell them to do. If they tell them to move to conservative states, they'll do it, because this is the perfect person to pick. You couldn't have picked a more perfect person. The other one would have been Pete Buttigieg as the vice president, but this is even better, because this guy's a lunatic. I mean, this is a guy that, you know, was all about the riots, the stage government riots that they were had out there during BLM. He was all for it. He's putting tampons in the men's room. He wants, you know, five-year-olds to get castrated. The perfect person to put in there, right? The ultimate opposition of Christianity in the Republican side. So the body cam footage literally coming out, the narrative continually being that the deep state's responsible. The conservatives, while the VP has been picked, are saying, oh, this is a slam dunk. There's no chance. Getting everybody in their mind to think, well, this will all be over in a few months anyway, and Donald Trump will get to the bottom of it when he's president again, because there's no chance that anybody would vote for Kamala Harris or this other guy. Because if they were going to pick anybody more competent than Biden, it would have been Kamala, which is why it's surprising, but it makes sense to do this. It makes sense for them to go, oh, look, she won. And for people to go, there's no chance that she won. There's no chance that anyone voted for her. There's no chance that this could be a president. This country is screwed. We're going under. We're going to be destroyed. We're going into World War III. We're going to have all the tampons in the men's room. It's all being deliberately done. So the body cam footage, let me know what you think about the body cam footage. I mean, it's laughable, because the first thing you just think is like, okay, why are they releasing it, right? Because they don't have to do this, right? We can look at the timestamp and we can laugh, but is anything more laughable than the police officers with no ladder helping each other up like this is some, you know, like this is two kids on the railroad tracks, right? Helping them up, and not only helping them up to look up there, seeing the shooter up there, right? It's not like he helped him look up there and there's no one up there. That still would be ridiculous, but he sees the shooter, and what is his first response? Oh, let me circle around and let me run away. instead of confronting the shooter, shooting the shooter. I am a police officer. I am supposed to protect the president. I mean, my mind would immediately be going, oh my gosh, I better do something fast. You know, if you want to think even further down in your mind, you'd be thinking about, oh my gosh, you could be responsible for this. If you don't take this guy out, he could kill the president. You could go to jail. You know, your response wouldn't be to run away unless you were, you know, a child or someone completely incompetent. But that's what they want you to think. Wow, he ran away. That is suspicious. He ran away. He's an idiot. He ran away. The Secret Service should have been there. Why weren't they there? Because the Secret Service did it, because Trump is going to save everybody from the deep state. This is all psychologically working on the masses. We're all seeing it on a day-in, day-out basis. The conservatives are taking it hook, line, and sinker, and they're thinking that all this stuff, with the media no longer covering the assassination, that all this stuff is, they're figuring it out, like as if the media is not gaslighting them and doing this deliberately to make them more, you know, more inclined to believe that the deep state's responsible. It's incredible. I thank everybody for being here. Hope you're all doing well. God bless you and your families, as always.